Well, this is a comforting thought to begin. ISIS, Al-Qaeda, and Taliban prisoners are now all out of prison in Afghanistan, and obviously under a friendly rule now from the Taliban, they can now reconstitute and begin trying not only to attack U.S. interests in the Middle East, but around the world and here at the homeland. Congressman Mark Green has fought terrorists on the battlefields of both Afghanistan and Iraq in the U.S. Army, Special Forces flight surgeon, worked with SEAL Team 6 and our Delta Forces as well. Congressman, appreciate it. Are we going to look back on the decisions of today the way the 9/11 Commission looked back on the decision not to kill bin Laden in the late 90s?
Well, I certainly hope so, Leland. Thanks for having me on your show. We absolutely need to get to the bottom of the intel failures that have happened here.
Forgive me, I think you misunderstand the question I'm asking. We had the ability to take out bin Laden in the late 90s. We didn't. Is the decision to give up Afghanistan in the way we have and allow ISIS and Al-Qaeda to reconstitute that same kind of decision to allow people who want to do harm to America a safe haven?
Yeah, no, absolutely. That's absolutely what's going to happen. We have allowed basically the Taliban the opportunity to create a haven for terrorists. ISIS, Al-Qaeda, they're all going to flock there and train up. This is going to come back to haunt us, especially with a southern border that's wide open. We will revisit this. Americans are at greater risk.
Well, we've got pictures of them all now out of prison. This is from Radio Free Europe and Radio Liberty. Richard Engel also had video of the large prison break once the Taliban came by. This would be the question, though, and you heard President Biden, I know you watched the speech, defending the policy of withdrawal versus how the withdrawal was done, which anyone can agree was a disaster, but the policy is different. The Afghans weren't going to stay and fight. We've seen this. Should the United States have kept men in harm's way indefinitely to keep from happening what you're describing?
So ask yourself this, Leland, and I heard you earlier in the show talk about basically two choices. There's actually a third choice, and that's the steady state we had right now. And that, yes, that's a little bit of force in the country, but it's way better than what we have now with the failed state. So that middle course would be much safer for the United States of America.
Isn't the fact that the middle course existed was because we had a deal with the Taliban not to attack U.S. troops? And if U.S. troops had stayed, the Taliban would not have been bound by that deal, so we would have had to put in more people?
Yeah, but no American has died in a year and a half, and most of the ground force battles have been done by the Afghan forces with support of the United States. So by us removing our support, you know, they basically lost their will to fight. And you talked about the corruption with your previous guest. So I think that middle state is a better place than we're in today.
Sufficing to say, that middle state option doesn't exist anymore, right? Ship sailed?
No, it's gone.
It's gone. Okay. As we look about what the implications are, we'll put up the map of what surrounds Afghanistan, some sort of, shall we say, unfriendly places. Iran, China, Pakistan, Iraq. Pakistan and China both have nukes. What are they thinking in Tehran and Beijing and Islamabad right now?
Well, just south of that is India, too. And, that, you know, talking to my contacts there, they're very concerned with the, you know, basically the disintegration of Afghanistan. You got nukes in Pakistan. You got nukes in India. And, of course, we got our strategic competitor there in China. It's a mess. And we have to consider very strongly where we put this over-the-horizon force. I'll be dropping an op-ed very soon that suggests maybe Northwest India. But the Taliban is in control of Afghanistan, and it's chaos.
Yeah, well, it certainly is chaos. I'm thinking not only about the people who are there right now who are going to be evac'd out, but there's, you know, hundreds of thousands of U.S. service members who served bravely. All of y'all lost friends and comrades and buddies. What's the phone calls going around those groups like today?
Well, it's very disheartening, Leland. I'm hearing from people who were already struggling with the unseen wounds of war, PTSD, things like that, that are calling, struggling with whether or not there was value to their sacrifice. And I would just tell every one of them, absolutely, for 20 years, that service in Afghanistan, those men and women who sacrificed there, were providing freedom from terrorist attacks here in the United States. That service was valuable. And any of them that are struggling, call my office, call Reboot for Recovery. You can go to rebootrecovery.com and actually talk to a counselor. Your service was valuable. Never forget that.
I can't think of a better way to end the conversation. Congressman, we appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Leland.